But without further ado, let's get going back on to the Obra Dinn. I really want to solve as many of these fates as I can before moving on. Right, so I want to go to chapter 3, I think, was it? No. Okay, so it's this, okay. So a bit of cold, so you see, I wonder if this is talking about somebody else, so we need to go and we need to go and find this scene. Is what we need to do. We want to go down again, I think. Yes, cause this is the gun deck. Alright, so this is the one we want. Listen, right, I'm going to listen very carefully. Listen carefully.
Her here. One swing. Get through the skull and stun her brain. I'll cut her throat when you've done it.
Here?
Yeah. Come on before she kicks up. You all right there, sir?
Never been on a farm, chap.
Mind your shoes now.
So, yeah, look, this is what we missed. So, this guy here, who we identified as, we haven't identified, but we can see he's used the axe. He's used the back of the axe, something I missed last night. So, this guy, he's our butcher. This guy is our butcher. And he is Irish. So, he's got to be Emil O'Farrell. There's another three. Good start. Fantastic start. Yep. Excellent start. Just what I wanted. All right, so who is this guy? He died in the escape. We don't know who attacked him yet. Okay, so okay, he's confirmed. He's confirmed. He's a carpenter. He's a carpenter's mate. So is there anybody else here with just wondering, is there anybody else with a call me Goobs, what's going on, buddy? Hope you're well. What's going on, Eddie, as well? Welcome along, Eddie. Welcome along. So yeah, I'm trying to think what song that is as well, and I can't think what song it is. I can hear it in my head, and I just can't think of the name of the song. Alright, so where else is this dude then? He says he's in 2. That's where he died, I think. Ah, there. So, okay, so he's just in there and there. What am I trying to do? I'm trying to find out the fates, my friend. I've uncovered everything on the ship, so everybody uncovered on the ship. And we now have the opportunity to leave the ship to have a look at Chapter 8. However, I'm quite apprehensive to do that because I feel if I go and do that now, I will not have the opportunity to play things back potentially on the ship. So I'm trying to tie up as much as I can. I'm trying to tie up as much as I can now. So we just identified this guy as our butcher. Okay, interesting. Burn the ship to the ground. I don't think that's really going to help. I'll be honest. So these people look like... these are all dressed the same. Or similar. So I think they're probably midshipmen. These guys are probably rigging people. I should probably get the bad ending. There's 3 endings. Wow. Okay. So, so we've got the Captain Steward. So these look like the stewards here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so would you advise to leave the ship, then, Eddie, and then go and check out Chapter 8, or? Okay. But it definitely saves before you leave, right? All right. So that's the doctor. Do we confirm his identity? He just disappeared in escape. So I'm pretty sure all these people just left. All right, so this is the guy that was. All right, well, okay. Let's go get the bad ending then. I'm taking your advice, Eddie. Like I said, I was just really apprehensive last night of leaving the ship. I just felt like I probably wanted to do everything I could before I left the ship, but no biggie. Alright, well, we're at 24 people. We're at 24 people on the identifications, so... said that about 2 hours ago.
If still business here, climb up and finish it. Else I'll make to port. Finally. Sit down so you don't fall out.
One week later. Honorable East India Company. Insurance assessment for the good ship Obra Dinn. Victims of calamitous events at sea. Prepared by the company office of investigation. Ship. Damaged in squall. Atlantic. Sunk in storm. Falmouth. Payment claimed £20,000. All cargo lost. Payout claimed £5,000. All cargo lost. Payout... for the crown, okay. This was in 1807, yes. I know, that is a lot of money. It's a hell of a lot of money. So, forfeit is the state to the crown. Yeah. He was shot. Attempted mutiny. Estate was fined £25. Attempted mutiny. Theft of cargo. £100. Okay. Murdered two people. Third mate. Mutiny again. John Davis, fourth mate, fate unknown, findings of merit, extraordinary valour, exceptional performance duties, estate award, outstanding wages, and reward at £90. So he was torn apart. Findings of merit, exceptional performance duties, estate awarded, outstanding wages, reward. Unknown. Right, so it's basically telling us the claims of everybody. Abandonment of crew and vessel, estate awarded. Yeah, so we know he's jumped ship. I just don't know where he's jumped ship to. Quite a few there that we don't know. Murder of crewmate, state unknown, expense claimed £25. Move a crewmate. Preliminary draft assessment has been approved by the Royal Trade Guarantor. £28,695 on behalf of Honourable East Energy Company. I certify the statements as accurate and declare this matter closed in its entirety.
Turning in now. Tea's all gone, so you might think about going to bed as well.
All right. Chief Inspector, I write to you with the unfortunate news that Dr. Evans has passed away. He succumbed to his illness shortly after receiving your package. Although his health was generally poor, receiving the Obra Dinn book in such incomplete state further disheartened him so thoroughly that he was unable to recover. He used his final moments to express the extreme regret he felt with entrusting such a remarkable task to you. We thought you should know, Jane Bird. Wow. Oh dear. So basically, because I did such an appalling job, the guy died. Oh, geez. Okay. Death by disappointment. I gotta write that down. That's gonna be the title for this YouTube video. Death by disappointment. quite nice to see in the credits, like, who visual representations of who these people voice act. That's quite a nice touch. Interesting. Voices.com. Quite like the soundtrack. Really nice soundtrack. Alright, so I'm guessing. I want to rewind, right? Is that what I want to do? Is it rewind, Eddie? Okay. All right. So, yeah, that's okay. So let's take a step. All right. So we are 24. Okay. Twenty-four down. Right, so we've got the bosun here. So, this is where we're going to get, it's going to be a little bit slow now. So we had the surgeon, we haven't found the surgeon's mate. Got the gunner, but we haven't got the gunner's mate. So I think one of these two here, are the ones that fled. But where did they flee to, though? That's the thing. I suppose we're going to have to go back through. Okay, so that is who these two people are. I just don't know which way around they are. It's one's Emily and one's Miss Jane Bird. One's Emily Jackson, one's Miss Jane Bird. So, if I had to guess, I would say that's her. And we know she is alive. But I don't know where they went to. If I had to guess, I would say Africa. If we go back to the escape, if we've gone to so, they're sailing east with the ship. You see, they could have gone anywhere. Perhaps need to go back to... This all happened here, and they said the ship was going to sail east. So it could be any one of these three places. It kind of looked like they were going backwards. The thing is, though, it's because we don't know what happened. Yeah, and this is where everybody started getting crushed and... I don't know, because we have nothing about Chapter 8 right now to go on. I did just have a think about this over here, though. I wondered if there was anything in here to tell us about the bosun's mates, because these are obviously their quarters. Yeah, things are a little bit slow. Well, that's a guy hanging out there, isn't it? Yep. So yeah, we don't know where they were heading to. Because chapter 8 is still a mystery. Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. I didn't look at chapter 8, did I? Maybe I should have left, and maybe I should have looked at the... So if I leave, can I look at chapter 8? Find out.
Hold on. We should go. Storm's nearly about, so we won't be coming back. If you've still business here, climb up and finish it. Else I'll make to port.
Okay, so I really need to find chapter 8.
Sit down so you don't fall out.
Also, I can't skip this. But yeah, chapter 8 is pivotal, I think, to find out where those people were going, those four people were going. I don't. Please tell me I can skip this. All right, let's hope I don't screw things up. That'd be unfortunate. Okay. So I'm going to get nothing from chapter 8 at the minute then. Okay. Good to know. So. Let's look for the arrows. So this guy, he's got one arrow. So that, I think, if I'm right, one arrow means I should be able to deduce his identity, I think. Use the book. Okay, so let's look. So he died in part 2. It said 4, right? I think this is to 4 Chinese top men. So this guy looks like he's wearing an apron, right? So see, I think these guys are Russians. Just because these are in... Are these the guys? No. Okay. No, they are. They are. They're in the bit of cold. And when we look at this... See, I still think... Is this two different languages, these two here? We know this is Indian. I wonder if that's two different languages. So this doesn't really help me when it's like, it tells me that there's, he's literally in like two places and one of them is in murder. Maybe I need to go back to that.
Huck Seng Lao, you have been found guilty by self-confession of the murder of Nunzio Pasquale.
Quiet!
As captain of this ship, and by the authority of the East India Company, and thus the Crown of England, I sentence you to death by firing line. Mr. Wolf, when you are ready.
Right, sir. Ready, men. Aim. Fire!
Right, so we know he's the artist. This guy, I think he's the cook. Carpenter. Still don't know who he is. Now, is this guy talking to the second mate? Or is he just coughing? He kind of looks like he's talking. So... He was Irish. Okay. So that's the third mate. Now, I mean, so he is possibly the fourth mate steward. Which would then make him third mate steward. I just go basing on that on we're basing that on the fact that they're all wearing the same sort of outfits, which would make sense, I think. Who did we say that was? Second mate steward, and he was from Ireland. The second mate is... Mr. Nichols. So he talks about Mr. Nichols, sir. So I think that's right. No, he's definitely Paul. All right. It's another three boys and girls. Alright, three more. And we're halfway. So, these people... These people... So these guys, I think, are going to be topmen. There's a lot of topmen. It's going to be hard to kind of pick those out at the moment. All right, so I need to find out who... Name begins with an N. This guy. So I don't know who he is, but he was killed by this guy. Okay. So, memories. So, where was it before here? Murder part one. All right, so. Yes, because it was a cover up. So, this guy is. This guy. Alright, because let me go back to. Where's the exit? Over here. So let's go back to the murder part one. He was being hung for the... Yeah, he was being hung for the death of that other guy. So, Hock Seng Lan. Oh, he's right there. Sorry. So yeah, Hock Seng Lang is this guy here.
Hello? Who is there? Who is that? Is someone hurt? Senor Nichols, is that you? What are you doing down here?
Hello, yes.
So, yeah.
Sorting some things.
Oh, sorry.
Watch your step.
So yeah, and then he framed him for murder. Jeez. He framed him for murder. So where did these guys escape to? No, I'm good at the minute. Thanks, Eddie. I'm good, thanks. The infernal serpent, he it was who's stirred up the envy and revenge, deceived the mother of mankind. That, yeah, that doesn't. I mean, again, that's just assuming I've got the right. So who's he stood next to? See, he looks like some sort of officer. Still not found the captain, steward. I mean, one of these two could be a captain steward. If I had to guess, I mean, he stood near the surgeon. All right, so let's go back to the escape. So, that's taking part up here, isn't it? Hold on, was it moved post-mortem? No. So, must be this guy.
One. Move quick.
Boy, you'll not take the last push.
Hold him down.
Let him go.
You see, I could have got this completely wrong. I mean, this could be Paul, but I mean, from where she's kind of looking and pointing. To listen to that audio again. I said this last night. I really wish there was a way that you could easily just replay the audio. See, I'm guessing he's a steward to this guy here. What's going on, Deathwish? It says that he would be easy to identify. Who's speaking to him? 20 years my steward and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself. So I don't really have any hints on where the people in that boat are escaping to.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. What madness is this? 20 years my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back, or doom us all.
Tie him up and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
Now, is he talking to John? As in fourth mate John, or is he calling him John? This is the guy that they're throwing. That's the guy that they are throwing. Right, so this guy. He is a steward. For which officers are present here? Hold on. You see, I think he sounded Scottish, but there's no Scottish stewards. So don't know if that's John. I'm going to take that off there. So we still don't know what happened to him. So hold on, he was taken. So he was taken through there. That's the butcher, that's the artist. It's Martin. That's the carpenter and his mate. It's one of the Indian fellas. This one. So it's not John. But he's talking to John, isn't he? Wait a minute, what was the... I wonder if the purser is around here somewhere. So that's John. So So I don't think he would be talking to John, because John is busy doing that. So that would strike me that he I'm hitting a rut. I don't know where the best place to kind of... So he was on the boat. Was he on the boat? Have I got these two the wrong way around? Because if that was the case... I wonder if that's the captain's steward. I would need to listen back to the captain's voice log. It's either William or the captain. It's either the first or second.
Keep pressure here.
Hold him down. What madness is this? 20 years my steward, and never a doubt on your sanity. Explain yourself.
Those ungodly beasts carry a curse. Throw them back, or doom us all.
Tie him up, and put him in the lazarette with those things. He may yet find his senses.
Come on.
All's fine, John. Been in worse spots, I think. Where's the rest of his leg?
I'm swaying towards first mate.
Open the door!
Kick it in.
Lest we break it down and take more than those shells.
You bastards may take exactly what I give you.
Alright, so that to me sounds... I think it's Captain, isn't it? So I think it's the captain's mate. All right, Eddie. No worries, buddy. Thanks for hanging. Catch you later. So I can't make a deduction at the minute of how he died. He was thrown in the lazarette. Which we can't get into. Alright, so I've got to go to her. Give us a weapon.
Where is it?
There! Something there!
I see it!
Give us a weapon! Shoot it! Mike and I!
Pick up the oars and row, you fools!
Yeah, I don't know. I have no idea. Struggles are real though now, as I keep saying. Where did they go? Where are the other memories then? Help. I just feel it's like it's almost like brute forcing. Where else is there near? I honestly don't know where else is near to where they were. All right, we're halfway. Halfway. Like I say though, it felt a bit brute forcey. All right, so anybody else? So, all right, I think we're good. So we can't set anything for him. Last memory. The Doom Part 8. Yeah, you see, I think I've got Martin and that's Martin. It's not John Davis, that's Martin. So I think he is the gunner's mate. He is John. He is We're getting somewhere. We are getting somewhere. Okay. So, let's go back to we know that was Martin. I'm going to say that's Paul still. Not the captain steward. What other stewards have we got left? The ship steward. Okay, that could be him. Alright, so this is the guy that was inadvertently shot, I think. So I can't see enough here. But yeah, he was... he was shot by a gun. Back another one. I
Because as the guy who... He's wearing like a white... That guy. I'm sure it's that guy. You see it through the like little letterbox on the side as you when you're down there. Got an apron on. I don't know. This guy, isn't it? Yeah, so that's the guy who inadvertently shoots the other guy. These guys fell from the rigging. That would make them topmen. See, I haven't got anybody at the moment. So it's difficult to... Where's the surgeon? I think these are midshipmen, but... All right, so let's get out of here. See, you could argue that he's been spiked, but I swear down he was shot. When you look back. You can see here where the bullet penetrated the wood. Yeah, it's definitely that dude.
Someone shoot the damn thing!
See that the bullet penetrates the thing here. Purser's office. So he could be the purser. Okay. All right, well, if that's the case, Alright, I need to go back to the escape. Nothing really happening here. So it's this guy, I think. This dude was killed by Emily Jackson. See, what happened to Martin after? That's the last memory of him, isn't it? So something happens to Martin in chapter 8. See, that's the... Yeah, so that's Henry Brennan. Wait, was the captain? Yeah, the captain's around here, because the captain's the one that says let them go. So, I'm saying he was knifed by the gunner's mate. crawled into there afterwards. He was over. Is he here? I was trying to think where he was playing cards. That might actually tell us. That might actually tell us where. So he's in the passengers. Okay. So is he just a regular passenger?
Sayed? Sayed Uto? Good feel.
There is no more. All up deck. What does it tell me about that? Mid deck, above the lowest deck, containing storage, cabins, animal pens, and the ship's steering tiller. Right, what? Well. Alright, so this guy. Let's see what I've got. One. Two. Three. Okay, so something's not right. Can't get round there. Only I could see. All right. edging that a little bit closer. So Lenoid was... So one of these other ones is 47. So one has a beard and one doesn't. That really helps, but all right, so now I know him though. He's confirmed. So, I'm wondering if he actually. Kills anybody else, but it doesn't look like he does. Okay. Let's go one. We've only got one at the moment. So this one's quite annoying. I'll tell you what though, can I? Hold on, maybe not, maybe not. So that's 47 and 45. If I come back down here, I wonder if I can see any more numbers. Oh, I need to put down. Okay. Really? They were on the gun deck, right? But yeah, the hammocks have been torn down. They've not been torn down, but they're not here anymore. It's a real shame. Unless they're still hanging in one of these.
What's going on?
Stay back. It's already over the lake.
Hey. Come on, boss. No, get there. Hey, cats!
Yeah, now all the hammocks and things are gone. All right, well. He's just chilling. All right, so So who was he shot by? So, we now know that he was killed by the fourth mate, John Davis. That guy was, yeah, he was killed by the gunner's mate. I don't know about the right way around for these people. Pete's mother, I tried my best to pull him back to save him. So, he tried to pull him back. So where is he? So he's listening on that, all of that he's listening in, isn't he? In this conversation, okay? If he's pulling him back, it's going to be... to the Doom. So I think this could be Pete. Unless that's Pete. Crawl back to his cabin, so he's got to be midship. Whew. We have completed all of chapter 3's now as well. Look at our achievements quickly. So we have all the fates in 1, 2 and 9. We haven't solved all the fates in murder, interesting. Okay, so I still don't know who he is. Okay. It's just this guy here is really... It's really bugging me. I made a mistake of skipping through the dialogue, and it's really hard to hear the dialogue when the music's playing over the background, so...
Well, same as the other fellow. Some lung disease, not consumption. Made worse by the cold.
Will it spread?
If so, we'd all have it. They must have picked it up at the Lasker house. I checked all hands just now, and everyone is healthy.
And him? What are his chances?
I gave him some laudanum. We'll see.
See, he's talking about two people. Famosan people. Yeah, I don't know if he is or not. So, don't want to jump to any conclusions for now. All right, so I think we're about done for tonight. We have made some mighty fine progress. Now, I want to just, before we end up the stream, let's see if we get, let's see what ending we get this time. Because we should get some sort of different ending this time. So yeah, we'll check this out.
All done.
And then we'll
go.
Call the stream.
So we won't be coming back. If you have still business here, climb up and finish it. Else I'll make to port. Finally. Sit down so you don't fall out.
All right, so I think it was at like 28,500 of an insurance claim on the previous one that we did. With 20, that was with 24 fates, I think. We must be either 39 or 42 now. Alright, so we're now at almost 29,000 pounds. Alright, so we'll return the book.
This hour. Must be important. I'll be turning in now. He's all gone, so you might think about going to bed as well.
All right, so let's read the letter, shall we? I write you with the unfortunate news that Dr. Evans has passed away. He succumbed to his illness shortly after receiving your package. Although the book was not fully solved, he asked me to express his appreciation at your attempt. He understood the difficulty of the task and that his final wish to see a completed book would not come easily. Of the four of us that survived the Obra Dinn's terrible ordeal, only three remain now. We are content with our situation here in Morocco, and request no further correspondence. Regards, Jane Bird. All right. So, we're at 39 fates, we've got 21 left to go. So that means we did We did 18 tonight. So at times, I kind of feel like we was... at times, I feel like we was doing a bit of... Sorry, just let me just check something. Henry is the surgeon. Just the surgeon that's, yeah. Well, we now know that they're in Morocco. I mean, we can't change it anyway. Like, we can't change his fate, even though he's dead. So yeah. At times tonight, it kind of felt a bit like I was brute forcing some situations. But, to be fair, I don't really know what else I could have done in some situations. So, the bed thing is still bugging me because I can't see that second number. So, I don't know which people, which other two. I know one of them, but I don't know the other one because I can't make out the other 40 number. So, it's definitely 40-something. But I just can't make it out. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll go and I'll take another look or something. Maybe see if I can superimpose it or something, or do something different at a later date. Probably tomorrow. Don't know why I said later date. I mean tomorrow. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with the progress, even though, as I said, times it kind of felt like I was brute forcing some situations. So we've got 21 more to go. Now I don't know... I don't know how many I've got left to do. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. All right, so we've got 19 more that we can actually solve. Which obviously means only two people. So we've got 19 more to solve. This is only two on chapter 8. And I think one of them... I'm pretty sure that one of them... ended up in the lazarette. The guy that they took... they tied up. And I've got him down as the captain's... the captain's... Stewart, I think it is. I'm sure that's who I said it was. So yeah, we'll come back tomorrow. We will go over all the clues again.
Let her here. One swing. Get true to Scotland, stone of rain. I'll cut her throat when you've done it.
Here?
Yeah.
And see if we can't come up with something else. Some more solutions.
You're right there, sir.
That'll be our screenshot for tomorrow.
Quest. Never been on a farm, John.
Maybe if I can actually get my. Oh, come on, Snip and Sketch. What you doing? I don't know. Oh, there we go. It's doing it now. Huzzah! There we go. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for tuning. I appreciate, as always, the continued support in the series. I feel at times it's possibly not been so enjoyable tonight. Because we are like so far in and we're literally just looking at every little tiny bit now, just trying to get every bit of information that we can out of this to kind of try and put the final pieces together. But yeah, guys, I appreciate the support. Like I said, thank you very much for tuning in. Links are on screen. Check them out if you haven't done already. I'm sure you all have. But until tomorrow, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.